This is from Satyam Tiwari, Nagpur. He asked, what is the proof that karma exists? And why did someone need to suffer in this birth for something they did in their previous birth? Is there any previous life as such?
Yeah, the proof that karma exists, because it's just like the Newton's third law of motion, is that for each and every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So we can see that. So if you're hitting very hard on a wall, if you're punching very hard on a wall, your head is going to break. So there is a reaction happening. So like that, here in this world also, if we are doing so many things, for example, if we are not controlling our diet, if we are eating, then the karma, we are able to see that you will get overweight, you will get obese, and then we'll get all kinds of disease and diabetes, and everything comes, blood pressure, everything comes, everything just because of uncontrolled eating. So there is a proof that karma is there. What is karma? Karma is, what is the first of all meaning of karma? With your karmendriyas, when you are using your karmendriyas to do an action, that's what is known as karma. So our karmendriyas, our main karmendriyas are legs and hands. Of course, legs, hands, voice, anus and genital. These are the five karmendriyas. So in that, with your legs and hands, when you are acting and all such things, so then you call it as karma. So that way, even eating is also a karma. You use your legs and you go to place and get the food ready, or if you eat with your hands and all such things. So that way, you see the proof is that if we are not following, if we are not controlling, if we are not doing the prescribed duties, then we are going to get problems. So like that, everything. So the karma, the proof, karma means the action, the activity. So you are doing it. So there is a reaction. So reaction is what you are going to get. So I just gave an example. So like that, there is so many examples you can give that karma is definitely there. And we are suffering for our past karma. So maybe our past karma in this life itself or in our previous life itself, because we are doing so many activities. We are binding us so much. We are committing so many sins in this material world. Maybe one life itself is not enough for us to suffer. So that way we will get suffering in the future births also for what karma we are committing. So we are bonded. So there is known as karma bandha. So janma bandha. So taking another birth in this material world itself is the effect of our karma only. Otherwise we won't be even coming back again here. So that way karma is definitely there. There is no doubt about it. So we have to really do with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita and do everything for the satisfaction of Krishna. Then we will be freed. Hare Krishna.
Okay, Guruji. So this means like the reason we are suffering in this birth is that whatever karmas we did in the previous birth was not sufficient to get the reactions for all the karma, and therefore something we are getting in this life. And then the third question again he asked, that is there anything like previous life? So in this life, if you are getting the karma for previous life, so then there should be a previous life as such. Okay, thank you, Guruji.
Also said in the Srimad Bhagavatam that we will also go to hell and suffer for our karma also. So there are a lot of punishments are given in the hell. Yamadudas, when they take us, and then all, for all our karmas, for all our sins, we need to go and suffer.
Okay, thank you. Yes. Thank you, Guruji.